Good morning, students. Students, after many more activities or after many more grammar activities, we have started our actual syllabus. And your syllabus, we have first chapter which name is sentences. And in the present chapter, we are going to learn what is meant by sentence. How can we define a sentence? Features of a sentence, parts of a sentence, then what is meant by phrase, and at last we are going to learn kinds of sentences. So students, according to you, what is meant by sentence, or how can we define a sentence? Sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense by itself. For example, I read a book. This group of words is making complete sense. That's why we can define a sentence as a group of words which makes a complete sense by itself is called a sentence. After that, we should know what are the main features of a sentence. When we discuss about the features of a sentence, at that time, the first feature of a sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense by itself is called as a sentence. Sentence always begins with capital letter. Then sentence always ends with full stop, exclamation mark and interrogative or question mark. Or a sentence has a verb. And a sentence is made up of two parts, that is subject and predicate. And after that, we have discussed about the kinds of sentences. Then what are the features of a sentence? Sentence is made up of a group of words which makes complete sense. Sentence always begins with capital letter. Sentence always ends with full stop, question mark and exclamation mark. Sentence has a verb. A sentence is consists of two parts. Of sentence is made up of two parts, that is subject and predicate. And after that, we have discussed what is meant by phrase. Phrase is also a group of words. But what is the difference between sentence and phrase? Sentence always is a group of words which makes a complete sense. But phrase is also a group of words, but it doesn't make a complete sense. For example, in the morning, in front of, in the evening, all these are phrase. Phrase is also a group of words, but it does not make any complete sense. This is the main difference between sentence and phrase. Then, what are the important part of a sentence? That a sentence is made up of two parts, that is subject and predicate. Then, how can we define a subject of a sentence or subject part of a sentence? Subject is that part of a sentence which tells us who or what the sentence is about. For example, the Indian team won the match. In the given sentence, the Indian team is a subject because it is telling about the sentence, and won the match is the predicate part of the sentence because it is telling about the subject. Each and every sentence has two parts, that is subject and predicate. Then how can we identify the subject part and predicate part? Verb is the essential part of predicate. In the given sentence, the Indian team won the match. Here, the team won the match. Here, verb is important. Whenever we try to identify the predicate and subject part of the sentence at that time, we should know that verb is essential part of the predicate. Then students, we have discussed about the kinds of sentences. Basically, there are four kinds of sentences in our language. Out of these four kinds, the first type is assertive sentence, the next one imperative sentence, and the third one is interrogative, and the last one is exclamative sentence. In next period, we are going to discuss about the structure of each and every sentence. How is the structure of assertive sentence? How is the structure of the imperative sentence? How is the structure of interrogative sentence? How is the structure of exclamatory sentence? In next period, we are going to learn about the kinds of sentence. So student, before that, read the chapter carefully. I will send the worksheet as well as answer sheet of those of the present topic. So have a nice day. If you have any problem, you can ask me anytime or you can call me. Thank you. Have a nice day.